doing business with you anymore. If you're going to have that sign there, you don't want people that have passed the background check, have been trained, have you know, gone through all the rigmarole that you have to go through, that you know are good people. Well, what do you know about all your other customers? Hey, you know nothing. And go, if they're a concealed carry permit holder, you know they're a good person. In general, generally speaking, they're mentally sound. They're not under the influence of alcohol or drugs. And they have a good head on their shoulders. They know how to handle a firearm properly. They've been trained. You don't know about any of your own customers like that. So why would you not want to have people in your store? You know what? Next week we come back and that sticker was off the door.
Why did they put it up?
Just because the anti-gun people went around and told them, and these are the ones from Ohio, told them, you need to have this sticker on your door. It's the law. That's what the anti-gunners told them. It's the law.
I'd say, show me.
So, yeah, it's a little bit of deception.
Well, surely they don't put that donut shop coming. There wouldn't have any cops in
it. Well, see, and what are you driving, ma'am? police officers, believe it or not, are covered under House Bill 218. If you actually, which is the federal law that states that law enforcement can carry in the 48 contiguous states anywhere, anytime. But in the state of Ohio, if you see the one sign that the state actually puts out, it says pursuant to the Ohio Revised Code 45. 29, whatever it is, I can't even remember. I can double it. Quote the Ohio Revised Code. And I can barely quote Bible scripture. But there is a line in there that says, unless you're covered under this, you cannot. Sure, go ahead. You can't carry a gun. That Ohio Revised Code states that if you're a law enforcement agent in the state of Ohio acting under the color of law, that you're allowed to carry concealed. So we can disregard those little stickers. Yes, sir.
Considering places like Kennesaw, Georgia, that have a local ordinance that every resident must have a firearm, how are you keeping track of how that's deterred crime? Or?
No idea. They're in Georgia. I'm an independent.
Right.
I mean, I'm not trying to be a smart aleck either. It's the only people who really know who's got what. In the city of Independence, we actually, I have to turn my firearms records over to them after a certain amount of time or a certain amount of days. So the police department knows that myself and the three other FFLs in the city of Independence, what we've done with our firearms and who has them, but they sit in the file and they don't go anywhere. All my records I keep, they don't get sent anywhere. So nobody knows who's got what, where, when, and how, for real.
Well, I was more interested in the concept, how well it's been working.
I don't know. I don't know. What's the crime rate down in Kennesaw, Georgia?
Well, I'd hope it would be less than when they introduced.
I mean, it sounds great, but in an ideal world, you're not going to find an entire community that, you know, is going to stand behind owning firearms or keeping them in their house.
Well, we can look to the Swiss, who also have a similar thing for military duty.
Yeah, they do. All right, is anybody else? Because I also have an engagement that my wife has.
Israel has
volunteered
a too. Everybody carries.
Yes, sir.
Have a military weapon. About everybody has someone in the military in every family. Yeah. Or they soon could be.
Not.
Well, only if they I was in Israel, this has been
if they're,
77
if I trying to shoot me and I take their firearm,
four,
and I shoot them.
If they're
continuing to be a threat, you have to be able to articulate that person is still a threat to you.
You do some target practice.
That's
16 to 60.
But if you just, like, you know, he pulls a gun on you and you, like, you know, do the Jedi mind trick and get this gun from him and you just take it on 2 weeks,
no, no.
Unless they're an actual threat. You have to be able to articulate not only to the police officers who are going to show up very shortly thereafter, but to 12 people and a judge of why you shot someone in cold blood if they weren't threat to you.
Yeah, well, I saw him marching down the street, all types of ages and sizes and everything else, carrying rifles and their weapons.
He came after me and a whole bunch of other people.
For inspection.
Again, it's how you articulate it. It's just like with anything, it's how you articulate it.
With all these,
You have to be able to weave a very masterful tale to get 12 people plus the judge to believe that.
Most of the cases, they probably are glad I shot them.
There are quite a few people who may agree with you. Again, you need to make sure those 12 sitting in that jury will, and the judge agrees with you too.
They always go after people they know don't have any weapons. But I see it in like Hillary, it's more of a control issue than being a coward.
So what is this?
Criminal, liar, a thief, everything else. And I think it's more than just being a coward. I think she wants to have everybody else disarmed but her. And just to give you a little insight, in the last couple of days, Trump's percentages have soared. And Alex Jones just interviewed him on the 2nd, and he said he was disappointed with the media because they would not contribute to the military or the veterans. He said they're making $40 million and every time there's a debate or more, and they wouldn't contribute a dime to the military. All about profit.
These Muslims killing people, that's what my husband was trying to warn them about. This is what Sharia law is. And can I get in trouble? Can he cite me for something?
Sure.
I just get so furious that I want to go down in a nice way and tell him that he's not a man of integrity and that he didn't even look at this and I want him to know where I am.
Where's his retirement party?
Yeah, go to his retirement party. Tell him there.
So can I get in trouble for
Yes, absolutely.
I can't?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Because all you need to do is say the wrong word the wrong way, and he can take it as a threat.
Okay.
And then you'll be charged with a felony of threatening a police officer. So
okay.
It's just best to let it slide.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Once he's retired, he's no longer a police officer.
Once he's retired, he's your prayer. Whatever you want within reason.
Whose reason? Some saying.
A gun show, portray yourself. Where did you go on the CC? How did you say keep it locked in the trunk in case you get stopped for a sliding through a stop sign or something?
Sure. Yeah, what we tell people is you separate the weapon from any ammunition that you may have, so they have to be completely apart from each other. So locked in the trunk would be great. With the trigger lock would be even better. You can throw it in the glove box if you want, as long as it's locked up and rendered inoperable. And if you can lock the glove box, do that too. I mean, better safe than sorry. It's called peaceable journey. And you're allowed to, there are certain ways that you're allowed to transport it in certain ways that can get you in trouble. So.
We better get on to the next step.
I'm sorry.
No. Thank you very much.
Oh, no problem.
The next step, cake over here. And have everybody get some cake and sit down and listen to the guy who gets the blue ribbon for the most patients here today.